All right, guys, so today we're going to be doing the Saiyan Warrior Race event. I was actually going to do the Goku Jr. event, but because this is actually available right now, I'm going to hold off on doing that until either later tonight or tomorrow. Also, the Ultimate Gohan has finally been added to DokkenBattleBuilder.com, so I will also be doing that at some point this weekend. Well, this weekend as in Friday, Saturday, since those are my days off. Anyway, for this event, we have two new Dokkan Awakens. We have Vegeta and we have Raditz, and they get their Dokkan Awakens. So let's go ahead and talk about the cards real quick. Originally, Saiyan Warrior Race Backbone, Raditz, Great Giant, or Giant Ape. Leader ability was Leader Skill, Ki plus 3, when HP is 50% or above. Decent if you don't have any other better leaders, but 50% or above is definitely a little bit more restrictive. His super attack is Double Sunday, causes supreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill, low class and lethal. Attack plus 7% per key orb obtained, rare chance to turn into Great 8. Great 8 mechanic obviously comes into play here. But 7% attack increase, not the best, but he was a little bit of a nuker back in the day. Or if you still try to run in one of those nuking meta. His link skills are Saiyan Lineage, Saiyan Warrior Race, Coward, Brutal, Beatdown, Nightmare, Transform, and Saiyan Roar. His max stats are HP of 8722, attack of 7681, and defense of 4699. And he has a 12 key multiplier of only 120%. Really bad 12 key multiplier, horrible. He Dokkan Awakens with 3 Nappa Metal. These Nappa medals are available from a new threat, Saiyan Warrior Race, and they are available. They're available on level 10, the Strongest Warrior Awaken. You get a Nappa medal over there, or the Moon Nappa, in order to Dokkan Awaken him. When he Dokkan Awakens into Atrocious Crackdown Raditz Giant 8. His new leader ability is when HP is 30% or above, Ki plus 3, and attack and defense plus 30%. Honestly, it's a lot better than what he was before. He's rainbow for one, so that's really cool. He doesn't have that HP buff, but he can help you out going up against the older events if you are a newer player and you have him. I'd recommend Dokkan Awakening him. Super attack is Double Sunday, causes supreme damage to the enemy. His passive skill, Rebellious Low Class Warrior, attack and defense plus 12% per key orb obtained, may turn into a giant ape 2 times now at most. So this is cool because he now gets the Technique Perfect Cell passive. He doesn't do that bad. I don't actually have a full calculation. I believe one was done here on this Reddit post. I'll go ahead and leave a link to the description below about that. So if you want to go ahead and look through all the math, I won't be going over it. But overall, really not that bad with that passive skill. His link skills are Saiyan Lineage, Saiyan Warrior Race, Brutal Beatdown, Nightmare, Transform, Saiyan Roar, and Shattering the Limit. He lost Coward. I believe that was the only one that he actually had lost to have Coward. And he got Shattering the Limit in place, which is really good. I only know that because of the one of the Reddit posts as well. Max stats are HP of 9021, attack of 7801, and defense of 4898. Overall, really solid for max stats without dupe system. And he has now a 12 key multiplier of 130%, which is definitely a little bit better. You don't want a 120 at all. 130 isn't horrible. You would prefer 140. But because he's a filler, well, I guess if you could call it a filler banner character, the Great Ape team is alright, it's pretty decent. 12 key multiple of 130%, you can't really knock it too much for a card that's really not that utilized as much. Next we're talking about the Warrior's Pride Vegeta Giant Ape. Leader ability is Agility type, HP and Defense plus 60%, really not that great. I mean, the HP buff is cool in defense, he's more of a defensive player in the game, so that's all there is to it. Super attack, Gallic Gun, causes supreme damage to the enemy. Passive skill is Serious Super Elite, attack plus 70% when HP is 80% or below. Rare chance to turn into Great Ape. That really sucks with that HP restrictive, 80% or below. That's never good. 30% or above is really the only HP restrictive that I can get on with, unless it's like 99% or below. Outside of that, when it's 80% or below, really blow. Link skills are Saiyan Warrior Race, Royal Lineage, Big Bad Bosses, Prodigies, Over 9000, Transform, and Saiyan Roar. Max stats are HP of 8013, attack of 8035, and defense of 4611. And he Dokkan Awakens with 3 Nappa medals as well. He has a 12 key multiplier of 130%, so he's off the bat better than the Dokkan version of the Great Raditz, I believe, in my opinion anyway. Overall, not bad. Cool unit. Again, the medals are on stage 10, Strongest Warrior Awakened. Dokkan Awakens with power of for the deathmatch Vegeta Giant Ape. I believe that's not the English translated version. Leader ability is agility type key plus 2, attack and defense plus 70%, so he's a little bit better. He's giving key now. Unfortunately, there's still no attack there, but It was HP and defense, yeah, and it's still HP and defense. Super attack Galakon, still supreme damage, no, nothing else added to it. Passive skill, Furious Super Elite. Attack and defense plus 70% when HP is 80% or below. May turn into Great Ape 2 times at most. Again, still being shafted without HP is 80% or below. Really sucks with that. Overall, what can you do though? It's the attack and defense plus 70% on a mono extreme team can come become useful. The thing is, he doesn't really have anyone good to link with on a mono agility team. Well, I'll go over that in a second. I think he only has a Great Ape Turles to do that with. I'll go over that in a minute. Link skills are Saiyan Warrior Race, Royal Lineage, Big Bad Bosses, over 9,000, Transform, Saiyan Roar, and Shattering the Limit. New max stats are HP of 8286, attack of 8279, and defense of 4669, and a 12 key multiplier of 135%. A lot better. Definitely overall really good card. That passive skill is the only thing that really shafts him. Other than that, he'd be a really, really good unit. At least in my opinion. So if this is the one that I was talking about, you can go over here to the right. You can pause it and type in the analysis of the URL if you want, but I should have it down in the comments below. If I forgot to put it down in the description, sorry, the description below. If I forgot to put it in the description, please call me out. Let me know. I'll go ahead and do it. This is also an entire Great Ape team, how it works with the analysis. So I'll also throw that in there as well. So let's go ahead and talk about the Raditz first. So I didn't click all these guys because there's just, first of all, so many, and as soon as I double click on one, the entire field got filled up. I couldn't do it to all of them, so they're going to be a little bit transparent over here. I put all the Great Apes on the right hand side just because it's kind of common sense that they're going to link with other Great Apes. We have the Great Apes though. You got Fasha, you have Vegeta, the Bardock, the Tora, Kid Goku's Dokken version. This is other Turles. I got man, I can't think right now. I started recording in the morning, by the way, guys, so, you know, I'm a little bit drowsy in the morning. You have Chugesh, Borges, and Nappa. So, obviously, these are going to be all the ones that he pairs very well with. It's odd, though, because I don't believe there's every single one of the Great Apes. Some of their Dokken versions he doesn't pair well with, so that's interesting. Maybe they just haven't gotten them yet. I didn't do the research on that. But these are guys who he, the SSRs are the ones that are all available on the global side, except for TUR Agility. So for global-wise, you're only going to want to focus on the SR variants. I'll move that over there. So everything in the left-hand column, except for this Vegeta and these SSRs over here, are the ones he links with. Now, I also did separately because I figured, you know, not everyone's going to have all the Great Ape. So let's go ahead and do the three key link skills with everyone. And that is where we're at right now. So this is the Turles. He links decent with Turles. He gets Battle, Saiyan Warrior Race, Breaking the Limit, and Nightmares, or Nightmare. And essentially, everything here is either going to be Saiyan Warrior Race, Saiyan Lineage, or Shattering the Limit. So essentially, that's what everything is. I'm just going to call out the noteworthy one. First off, you have the Karoli. If you guys have him, he's pretty decent. Battle, Ethic Saiyan, Saiyan Blood, Breaking the Limit. We have Masked Saiyan Bardock, which is currently not available on the global side, but he should be around the corner. I think he's going to be out very soon, just because we got that technique banner. So, he only links three times. Cruelty, which is brutal beatdown. 10% on the JP side. I believe it's just a flat-out boost on the actual global side right now. Saiyan Warrior Race and Saiyan Blood, so that's good to take into consideration. The Dokkan version of Barlot, so that's cool. Shattering the Limit, Saiyan Blood, or Saiyan Lineage, and Saiyan Warrior Race. The Intelligence to Burra, nothing to really write home about. The Strength, Evil Boo, which you guys should be able to get up a Super Deck 10 if you summon enough, because he has the SR physical type variant. Then we have the SSR variant of Mass Saiyan Bardock, which is Cruelty, Battle Ethic Saiyan, and Saiyan Warrior Race, or Saiyan Lineage. Then we have the Corolla, I can't really think about anything right now. The Bio Broly. I think this is the Baba Shop Nappa as well, Cruelty, Saiyan Warrior Race, and Breaking the Limit. And then the future Vegeta, the extreme intelligence type. So the noteworthy ones are really going to be Mass Saiyan Bardock. And really that's it, maybe Barlap, but he's not going to run on an extreme team. So in terms of extreme team, the Mass Saiyan Bardock is going to be really useful for him. Since he is, I guess it's technically a Rainbow Leader, because you could have him on Rainbow Leader. Better on a mono villains team. But he can link with any of these guys. He's not going to be the best linking buddy, but if you have any of these characters, if you're a newer player, these are the ones you're going to want to go for. You can go ahead, pause the screen if you need to see if you have any of these. Or you can go to DokkanBattleBuilder.com yourself and put in the Great Ape Raditz and see who he links with and he'll link better with on your team. Anyway, so the next one is going to be the Vegeta. And of course, same setup as before. We have all of the Great Apes over here. We have Turles, Kid Goku, Fasha, Raditz. Have this is Bardock, I think this is. I can't really say. I think that's Bardock. We have Nappa, Tora, and Borges, and Shuget. So he links with all of them, obviously. And then we have down here. So he links well with the TUR and the LR mod from Vegeta's. So keep that in mind. He does really well on that Mono Extreme Agility team. So he gets Break Limit, the Saiyan Lineage, and Battle Ethic Saiyan. So the Saiyan Warrior Race is Battle Ethic Saiyan. Is only 700 attack up, flat out boost. Not amazing, but he does have it. And he has what? Breaking the Limit and Saiyan Lineage, which is key plus 3. So if you're lacking lane characters for an LR Majin Vegeta, if you happen to have them, there you go. Also, who runs well on that team is going to be the Agility Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta, which is the same exact link set. So right there, these guys can form 4 on a team, or I'm sorry, 3 on a team, because it's, one's TUR, one's LR, you can't run both of them. But if you have LR Majin Vegeta, you could run him as your leader, and then you have the Super Saiyan 2, and you have Great Ape Vegeta. So that's just something to keep in mind. You don't need to run them. I'm just saying that's something that consider. Then obviously you have Trunks. Well, one of the Trunks is. And it's the Technique Trunks that really links well with everyone. He links the same exact link skills as those guys. Then you have the Nappa. And then you have a whole slew of Vegetas over here. The Technique Vegeta over here, he links well with almost anyone. The Physical Vegeta, also pretty damn cool. He's the one when he Dokken Awakens, he debuffs the attack of the enemy. So really well, I think it's by 40%. So double attacks on him would be freaking phenomenal. Anyway, you can link up with any of these four Vegetas. On the global side, we're kind of limited because we don't have these two yet. And I don't think... Yeah, I think we have everything else over here. Do we have the Dokken version of the Super Saiyan Vegeta? Let me know down in the comments below. Then we have the Technique Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta. And then we have the two other Turleses over here. We have the Intelligence one and the Technique one that was a World Tournament reward. So he links well with each of those as well. In terms of viability on a team, maybe I could see you running a Turles on a team. And LR Majin Vegeta, obviously what I was talking about before. But outside of those two, I don't see you running maybe the Intelligence one, but I don't see you running those two on the same team. Because this Intelligence is going to be on a Mono Intelligence team, and there's no reason to run that on with the Vegeta. So that's not someone that you're going to really run with. Overall, yeah, I think the only two is going to be the LR Majin Vegeta and this Turles, and maybe the Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta's Dokken Awakening. I don't see you running him alongside anyone else outside of the Great Ape. But anyway, guys, that's it. This has rambled on a little bit long enough. Apologize for not being clear in the head in the mornings. I'm trying my best to get you guys videos, but I'm trying to get myself on a new schedule so that way I can, you know, get into a new workout routine and try and get myself healthy, because I've let myself go in the past year and a half, 2 years. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. Go on and hit that subscribe button if you are new. Stay tuned. I'll be doing the Goku Jr. event tomorrow or tonight. Depends on what happens when time I get home. But anyway, guys, thank you. I appreciate you taking the time to come by, watch my video. I'll catch you all later.